From deep inside the Death Star, I'm Chad Beeder.
Hey, all, I'm Ojasvi Choudhary.
And I'm Jorge Novillo.
And welcome to Defrag Tools, the show that takes you inside Microsoft and inside Windows. We've got Ojasvi and Jorge here today. Why don't you introduce yourselves a little bit and tell us what you do, Ojasvi.
Sure. So I'm a program manager on the Windows kernel power management team. I'm responsible for processor power and the Windows thermal framework.
Awesome. Jorge's been on the show before, repeat visitor.
Yeah, so I'm on the strategy and ecosystem team, and I'm working closely with OEMs and ODMs on basically enabling them to deliver longer battery life in their devices.
Awesome. So we're going to talk about a new feature in recent versions of Windows 10 that people have probably seen, I would expect, the power slider, right? Everybody's seen this. Maybe if you've got a laptop, you click on the battery icon, you see this new slider there. So what is the purpose of the power slider? Let's kind of give a little bit of a, how do we get to this point?
So the power settings in older versions of Windows are kind of buried, and so they're not very accessible from the top level UI.
Right.
And so in the recent versions of Windows, we wanted to add this slider to give users more control so that they can decide whether they want to favor performance or power.
Right.
And so it is available from the top level UI, as you mentioned, if you click on the battery icon here.
Right there.
Right now we're plugged in, and so and we're on better performance, but there's different slider positions here.
Right.
And you can essentially change between better battery and better performance based on what you're doing. So for example, a couple months ago I was going to WinHack in Asia.
Right.
And I had two flights. On the first flight, I did not have access to AC power, and I wanted to make sure that I maximized my battery life. So I switched it over to the battery, better battery position.
Right.
And so once I was on my second flight, I actually had access to AC power, and so I decided I want to make sure that, you know, Windows is performing snappy, I get the fastest results. I believe at the time I was transcoding a video from the previous weekend. I had shot my son's basketball game, and so I wanted to stitch it all together and
make sure you get the fastest transcoding.
That's right. That's right. So then in that case, I switched it all the way to the best performance position.
Right. So I guess the idea then is it's just more surface, right? Because we always had this, like you said, down deep in the control panel, you had these like balanced and like power saver and all that. But I don't know how many people ever even went and touched those, right? Because it's kind of hard to get to. Maybe a lot of people don't even know it's there. So it's sort of the evolution of that, right? So does it work on both AC and DC? You showed it on both, right? So clearly it does. But is that something like, does it remember the settings? Or?
Yeah, it does, actually. So the way it works is we have three positions on AC and four on DC, just because we want to give users an extra edge in saving battery life on DC.
Yeah.
Another neat little thing about this is that if you are on AC versus DC, we give you the option to choose different notches for both.
Okay.
So like in Jorge's position, while he's on AC, he can choose to have the slider be more performant.
Right.
And when he's on DC, he can select a more energy efficient position. And as you switch between modes, the slider automatically will remember your settings and, you know, make sure that you're in the right mode.
So you don't have to remember every time you plug it
in.
Oh yeah, I always like it on this setting.
Yeah, yeah. So
right, it'll just stick.
It just sticks.
Is that a per user setting?
Or yeah. Okay. So that's whatever is the last position that you had on AC or DC is the one that we go back to every time there is a transition.
Okay, cool. Now, I know sometimes I don't see it there, like my desktop computer back at my office, I don't see it. Like what, if I don't see it, what are the reasons why I wouldn't see it?
Yeah, so you have to be on a recent version of Windows 10.
Right.
And it has to have a battery, of course.
Right.
So we don't
right.
offer this on desktops.
That would be why.
The second thing is the legacy power plans, right? We used to have Power Saver, Balanced, and High Performance.
Those ones that you had to drill through the menus to
exactly.
get
to. Exactly, they're a few levels deep. So you have to be on Balanced in order for the slider to appear.
Okay.
So
if you've
those are a few
gone
things
in
to check.
Maybe and changed that somehow previously, then it might not
exactly.
show up.
Yep.
Okay. So that's a kind of a key thing, I guess, for those power users that may have tweaked that. They may not see that. So exactly what does it do? Like, we've talked about sort of the point of it, right? Which I guess is kind of obvious, but like, how does it work? Like, what is it actually tweaking?
Yeah, that's a good question. So there are two knobs. The first one is processor power management. Mm-hmm. So essentially, you know, we have algorithms, power management algorithms inside the OS that we used to understand, okay, what are the workload and the user needs? Like, how performant does this application need to run, or is the user, does he want to optimize towards battery life at this moment? Mm-hmm. And we essentially understand the workload and go configure the processor to run at more efficient frequencies, or, you know, or to be more performant.
Okay.
So the one thing that we are tweaking across the slider is how responsive versus how efficient the processor is across all four knobs.
Okay, so these are settings that yeah, processor settings that are exposed to us by the processor vendor, perhaps,
yep,
and different sort of tuning parameters that they give us, right? And so we work with them,
yep,
to kind of optimize those for different scenarios?
Yeah, sure. So we have two knobs in the OS. The first one is processor power management. So Windows 10 has processor power management, or as we call them, PPM algorithms that, you know, allow the OS to efficiently balance between the user's need for performance and battery life.
Okay.
We also, in our understanding of workloads, we see, okay, for particular workloads, what is the way to run them most efficiently without compromising on performance.
Okay.
So taking all those things into account, we try to optimize the silicon.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and this is the what we call the EPP, is that right?
Yeah. So, the people watching, they can go to this MSTN page, and we've got all this documented. There are a ton of settings that we have across silicon vendors. Mm-hmm. EPP is one of the settings that we optimize with the slider. And EPP essentially stands for energy performance preference. It's a scale from 0 to 100, 0 being the most performant, 100 being the most efficient.
Okay.
And, you know, we'll work with the silicon vendors to ensure all of this is in box and configured, tuned perfectly for their chipsets.
Okay,
yeah.
So that's the first thing we do. Yeah. And is there a way to go in and see, you know, what those EPP settings are for each position of the slider?
Sure, yeah. So we have a script over here that Jorge wrote. So essentially, you have these power config commands, right? You can type these in and it'll give you what are the settings for each slider position. We'll just run through it really quickly here.
Okay.
So the first one is the better battery position.
Okay.
So that's the command. And so we're configuring the EPP value over here.
Uh-huh. And I see they go
from
the
better
like
battery. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And you got these. So minimum is 0, maximum is 64 hex, which is 100 decimal, like you said. And then these are sort of
AC and DC. So we have different values on AC versus DC. It's slightly more performant on AC than DC.
This one's on balance, which maps to the better performance position on the slider.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
And the last one that we have is best performance. So over here we have
a little bit longer.
Yeah, we have a few more settings here. So the EPP setting, for example, over here on AC is on 0.
Okay.
Which is like to its highest performance.
So again, there with those EPP stuff, that's something that we work out with, you know, the silicon vendors. We work with them to kind of tune that. That's not something that a user really needs to worry about so much, other than you can see what they are.
Yeah.
You said there was another knob, though, right?
So
that we can tweak when we change the slider.
So the second knob is power throttling. Essentially, stuff that is in the background applications, we run them at the most efficient processor frequencies, such that the user ends up saving more battery life in the long run.
Okay.
And Jorge is going to, you know, talk more about that in a while.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So are there any ways to, like, opt out of this? Like, you mentioned, like, the power throttling, like, background apps get throttled down. Like, say I don't want that. I mean, I guess I can, you know, like, what if I just want the best power or the best performance at the expense of power?
That's a good question. So, yeah, Ojasvi covered the first knob that we have that operates behind the scenes when the user's switching from better battery to better performance to best performance, right?
Yeah, yeah.
The second knob is called power throttling, and this is something that is user configurable. The first one, the EPP and the processor tuning, those are not user configurable, right? It all happens behind the scenes.
Okay.
Power throttling also happens behind the scenes, but there is some things that the user can do to either opt out or just have more control over which apps are power throttled.
Okay.
So the best way to see this in action is to launch Task Manager.
Okay.
We're going to click on More Details and then go into the Details tab. Mm-hmm. And then if we right click on the columns and select columns, and then we're going to scroll down to power throttling.
Okay. Right there.
Yep. And then we're going to hit okay and then drag this new column over here.
Gotcha.
All right. So let's see what position we are in right now. So best performance. So this is option number one to opt out of power throttling.
Oh, okay.
You switch the slider all the way to best performance. If I were to switch it to better performance, you can see now here power throttling is enabled for a bunch of different apps.
Okay. And these are just apps that are not foreground windows,
essentially. Exactly. Yep.
Okay.
So if I were to scroll down in this list, you'll definitely see there are some that are not being power throttled.
Okay.
So there are exceptions, like real-time communications. If you have Skype in the background,
sure,
it's not going to power throttle Skype, right?
I noticed like audio DG, which is what drives your audio. You don't want that throttled down because you'll probably get audio glitches and things.
Exactly.
Right? So there's some. It's not just every background app. There's some logic to it, right?
Yep.
So this essentially means that these apps are not getting to like throttle the CPU up to the max speeds or get, is that?
Yeah, so basically like the threads that are being scheduled,
okay,
are still being scheduled.
Mm-hmm.
They're just happening, they're running at a lower frequency basically. So the work's still getting done, mm-hmm, it's just a little bit slower. And so
Right. Theoretically
the user should never notice it. They should only notice better battery life because they're not interacting with the app, right?
Right.
So here's an example. I've got Notepad right here running in the background. If I were to click on it, we can see here Notepad. Oh, it just moved because I'm sorted by power throttling. So let me scroll down here. Now Notepad has been disabled.
Okay.
So as soon as I move it back into the background, Notepad's going to jump back up to the enabled status. There it is.
Right. Okay.
So
we've enabled throttling because it's no longer in the foreground. I mean, it makes sense why spend cycles on Notepad when you're not actually typing in it, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay. Yep. So there's a couple other ways to opt out of power throttling besides the way I just showed you, which is to push the slider all the way to the best performance. So
uh-huh,
the second way to do this is basically to plug into AC power. So I'm going to go ahead. Notice how Edge is being power throttled. If I plug this guy in, we are now on AC power, and then power throttling is disabled. So basically, power throttling only applies to DC power.
Okay.
The first knob that Ojasvi went over with all the processor tuning, that applies to both AC and DC.
Right.
Right. There are different values on AC and DC, but that principle applies to both.
Okay.
So the third way to kind of take control over power throttling for those power users out there,
mm-hmm,
is to opt out specific apps in the battery usage UX. So let me go into Battery Saver. I'm going to click on Battery Usage by App, and then let's find Edge. So I'm going to uncheck the box that says Let Windows Decide When This App Can Run in the Background, and then I'm going to uncheck the Reduce the Work the App Can Do When It's in the Background. So if I do that and I switch back over here, now we can see power throttling. Oh, let me just unplug from AC power. So now you can see some apps are being power throttled right here.
Right.
But if we scroll down to Edge,
Edge is still not throttled.
There we go.
Okay. So that could be useful. Like I would imagine maybe your example of like encoding a video or something, which wouldn't necessarily be in the foreground window, but you want
it
to keep running full speed even if you're on battery.
Exactly.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Right on. Are there customizations that OEMs can do to these, like to tweak this? I know we have some people that watch that work for different companies in the industry. Like, what kind of customizations are there for this?
Yeah, so Jaws, you mentioned earlier that the OEM can customize the default slider position. So for example, let's say an OEM is shipping a mobile gaming machine.
Mm-hmm.
They may want to switch the default position from better performance to best performance, right? We don't necessarily recommend it because we do want to have a balance between battery life and performance, but
right,
it's an OEM's option to do that, right? The other thing that we really want to raise awareness on with partners is the ability to define unique performance settings in their firmware for each slider position. So this is actually the number one question we get from partners at forums or WinHack, is how do we customize the slider? How much can we do? How much control do we have? And so back in the day, we've had this add power directive, something like that. There's a feature that allows you to define unique settings for the legacy power plans. So power saver, balance, high performance. Right. You can say, I want my fan speed to be capped out at 50% in power saver mode, right?
Right.
So if you take that same exact concept and same exact mechanism by which you would define those values and apply them to the slider, that's available today. And so Ojasvi wrote exercise 2D in the WinHack Power Lab. So I encourage you to Bing the WinHack Fall 2017 Power Lab, and you should have access to this lab here. And so in exercise 2D, we have an example. It's kind of like a dummy driver where it's a fan firmware driver that essentially defines unique values for each position on the slider. So then if I were to switch from, let's say, better performance up to best performance, let's say the max fan speed would go from 75% to 100%.
Right, right.
And so you could apply the same type of logic to thermal and other perf and battery life related components that you ship and that you're responsible for.
I'm imagining like hardware partners may not only have just fan speed on the chassis, but maybe on the graphics card, they maybe want to be able to tweak that through this or something as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Different ways to sort of configure components in the system if they have a driver that they want to plug into this slider framework.
Right? The one thing that we don't really want to see is we don't want partners shoving a bunch of functional changes in there, right?
Right.
So there is one change that we made where if you switch into the battery saver position, we will reduce the screen brightness by 30%. So that is kind of a functional, it's saving battery, right?
Yeah,
but it's also kind of functional. The user sees something change, right? And so other than that, this slider is strictly designed for managing basically perf and power. There's really, we're not trying to tie in like disk timeout or other functional
sleep
aspects.
Sleep timeouts,
yeah, exactly.
Oh, right, because sleep timeouts, for example, is something that the user may just go in and set, right, in the control panel. They expect that to stay, right?
Exactly.
So, that makes sense.
Yeah. Well, but I think it's just we want them to have, we want the slider to be a power performance trade-off, not necessarily a power functionality trade-off.
Exactly.
Okay. So something to keep in mind if vendors want to go and implement this and plug their own stuff into it, right?
Yeah.
And this seems to be the direction we're headed, right? So this slider paradigm away from sort of the old legacy power profiles that you had to dive in through the
through the
legacy control panel and nobody ever looked at. So this seems like the way if people want to kind of integrate with this, this is where they want to do it.
Absolutely, right? Yeah. And one thing that we want to make clear is we understand that there are some OEM apps that do similar things, right? I've heard there's apps that, for example, may look at the cycle count of your battery, and then after a certain, after you've reached a certain level, suggest, hey, here's how you go buy a new battery for your system. We detect that it's getting old, right?
Right.
And so some of these apps theoretically could get out of sync with the slider because they have their own kind of idea or concept, similar concept. And so what we're looking at in the future version of Windows is the ability to query the current slider position from those apps.
Ah, okay.
And that way that'll hopefully keep things in sync.
Give them an API to programmatically get into that. Cool. All right. Well, that seems pretty comprehensive. Anything we've missed?
I think we covered everything.
Right on. Well, that's the power slider and what it does under the hood. So, thanks you guys for coming and
thank you.
Demonstrating that for us. And if you have any questions or comments, put them in the show notes down below or email us at defragtools@microsoft.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.